Okay, I'm back with part three of making up this little traveller's notebook style journal, or insert for your traveller's notebook. So I went away and I sewed the tippins and the fabric pocket, which I talked about doing, and I sewed on the lace on the edge of the pages. I decided to do that on the back page as well, and then I did this little pocket, but I turned the fabric over because it was like this. It was like that, but I decided I preferred the browner side, so I turned it over. On there I've just put a little bit of the butterfly ribbon sewn on. There's another little tip in there. So that's all the pockets and tuck spots in and sewn. So now I'm just going to go in and maybe just, I mean, it's fine as it is, you know, I could happily leave it like that, but I wanted to use up as much as possible of this little paper kit that I put together. So I've got some bits left. I'm going to just decorate some of the pages, but I'm not going to do anything on the blank writing pages because I want to keep them, you know, freed up for writing space. But I thought, like, on these designer papers I could put something on there maybe. So I did have a little think about it beforehand, and decided I might do something like this. Just a little bit of layering. Got these a couple of bits of wallpaper cuttings left, so I quite like the idea of something like that. So I think I'm just going to go ahead. I'm not going to think about it too much. It's just going to be an incredibly long video if I do. So I'm just going to go. I'm just going to say, yeah, that goes there, and then I'm going to glue it down. So that one can go there, and then I'll just distress the edge. I won't do too much distressing, but I can't, not very good at leaving things undistressed. I just can't get out of the habit. So I think I want to glue that like that. So I'll use my I'll use some tacky glue, I think, today. Hopefully it'll come out of the, I'd say you can use any glue you want, because I know people like to use glue sticks and things for stuff like this, but I don't find they stick very well. They do initially, but they always seem to come off in my experience. So something like a tacky glue will stay on. So this is just a page from the Shakespeare plays book. There was a couple of pages that included. And just gonna finger works just as well as a brush, this type of glue, and then I will stick that on there. Just smooth it out. So I'm hoping in this part I'm going to get some of the pages decorated, and then whatever's left I'm going to make some kind of tags and things, and then I'll do them off camera, because otherwise I'm going to be here, you know, it's going to end up being about six videos. So I'll make them off camera, and then I'll just talk you through what I did, and then we'll do the cover, work on the cover. So there's the other side of that one. So I'm going to do a similar thing here, another piece of wallpaper. I was thinking of using some of this. This is a piece of Edith Holden. It's just like an index from the back of the book. I like to rip things. I was thinking of rounding all the edges on the all the page edges, but ideally should have done that first because of the cover, but so I think I'll leave that. But rounded corners do look nice on these new travels notebook style. You just it's got a 10mm round edge corner, you know, round corner punch, so that's what I would sometimes use, but that should have been done before I started all the sewing really, so I'll leave it for now. It's just something that you might want to consider if you're making one and you've got a corner punch. So I'm going to put that down there like I did with the other one. This is an idea I use quite a bit. It's just putting a piece of torn book page down. I just think it looks effective. I like the look. Oops, oops. So I'm just going to put that on that side. I'm going to put this here, but it's a bit too big, so I'm just going to cut it down a little bit. So I'll get my rotary cutter, and I can certainly cut some off the bottom, because I've got plenty of room at the bottom, so get rid of some of that. And the top edge is not quite straight, so and then maybe a little bit off the side, a little bit too wide I think, so just a little bit off that side. See how that looks now. Yeah, that's a better fit. I'm going to put that down the bottom there. And again, I'm just going to use my finger to get the glue into the corners. And it is good glue, this tacky glue. It does it grabs really well. So that looks nice there. So you've got pretty wallpapers. Totally free papers for your journal. So there's quite a lot of junky stuff in here really. There are some obviously designer papers, but we've got just plain copy paper, and then there's book pages and wallpaper. So it is a, you know, does include some junk in the true sense of the word really. So that's that one. And I was thinking of these flip out pages. I was thinking of putting a strip of some of the off cuts off one of the papers. I've just cut into thin strips to make like a paper washi. And I was thinking of just putting that on the edge there, just to add a bit of interest. I'm just going to cut that a little bit long. That's what I'm going to do here. I'm going to put a piece of paper washi. So put the right way up, just on the edge, just to add a bit of interest to that plain page. Still a bit long, I'm trim that off when it's finished. So we're doing the other side of this as well, aren't we? So, oh no, I'm not doing the other side of that. I'll just trim off the like so. And then I've got another one of these somewhere as well. Yeah, this is it. So I'm going to do the same with this one. With a piece of paper washi, I call it. I don't know if that's the right term, but I just move the glue about with my finger. I'll make sure it's the right way up, because it is the script. I think that's the right way up. It's been raining really heavily just before, and it's quite dark. So we had some lovely bright sunny weather for weeks, and it was quite nice earlier on actually, but it's just rained and it went really cold and thundered, and so it's getting a bit autumnal already, and it's only August. Right, so I've decorated that page. I'm not going to do anything with the ledger pages because I think they're quite interesting, and obviously the space to write on there. I wanted to do something with that, but I can't remember what I was going to do. Yeah, I wanted to put something there as well. So I might just put a bit of just rip that again. Okay, just to add a bit of extra interest and layers, it's texture and things like that, so I can go there. Let's get some good old Edith Holden. I don't know what a lot of us would do without her books, really. Right, so that's that patterned page sorted. That one. I've edged that. I'm going to leave that. There's quite a bit of writing space. Got a nice book page. You've got that. So the only other one is maybe something on the back of this. Again, it'll just be, I don't know, maybe this little quote. I'm not going to try and rip this because it's quite difficult, so I'm just going to use my, crinkly scissors, which is struggling to cut this wallpaper actually. It's a shame. They're not, my crinkly scissors won't cut it, so I'm going to have to tear it. It's quite fibrous, this paper. I'll just have to tear it off. That was just off the other piece that I'd used before, so I know, something like that, just I don't know. Maybe just there in the middle. Put that there. Probably should have inked that actually. I didn't. I might ink it later when the glue's dry. I might just rub a bit of ink over it. So yeah, I think that's about it for the pages themselves. So I've got left now some book pages. I've got the offcuts and I've got the trims and buttons. I'm going to use these on the fabric and some on the cover in some way. And then I've got some buttons and things as well, so that's what I'll be doing next. I'm going to go away, I'm going to make some embellishment, some tags and things, use up as much as I can, and then I'll come back and show you what I've done. Right, well, I went away and I made a few embellishments with the papers that were left. It's a little notebook with some leftover pieces. I put some of the broderie on grey trim and a couple of buttons on there. Made a little envelope style piece of journaling paper. The little envelope that the buttons were in, I've decorated it with some of the trims, put some of the book paper on, and inside just a couple of little pieces of spare journaling paper. And then out of the offcuts of the cover paper, I've made two large tags, and on the back I've just done some collage for the book pages and a little bit of ledger paper, and then I've put a little bit of the trim as a tab, and here I've put the little press stud or snap vintage one on there just for a bit of decoration. And then I have this that I was going to include in it, so that's going to go in. So they're the embellishments I managed to make out of what was left, because all I've got left now, besides what I'm going to use for the cover, are these little bits here. Just a couple of little bits of paper, probably won't use them buttons, and a little tiny bit of trim. And for the cover, I'm going to use this, like I said before. I've cut it to size and I've frayed it, and I'm going to arrange that somehow with the piece of ribbon that's left, which I'm going to incorporate and make into some sort of a tie and put a button on and wind it around, but I'll come back and show you that when it's all done. So all I need to do now to get this, I went in again and I put a couple of pieces in these flip out pages just from the book pages that I've done, just the little advertisements. I just put one on each page just to add interest. So this is ready to be sewn together now. So I love how easy it is to put a traveller's notebook, you know, how easy it is to bind it. So you just need to get all your papers, and if you've got any shorter papers, make sure they're obviously in the position that you want them, and then I just clip them here and here, and again at the bottom. And then generally a 3-hole pamphlet stitch will do for this size journal, or you can do a 5, but for sort of speed of the video, I'll just do a 3-hole one for now. And I did include a piece of thread in with the pack that I've used, which is plenty long enough for a 3 or a 5, but I'm just going to do the 3. I've got my, this is actually a bookbinding needle I bought a pack ages ago, and this is a kind of a medium size one. And then I've got my awl to make the holes. Generally do it use an old book, get into the, put my thread down, just put it into the, some people use like telephone books or, you know, thick magazines, but so then I just eyeball it with these. I'm just doing 3-hole pamphlet stitch. I kind of eyeball or roughly measure. So I want it to be about there, it's about the centre. Put one hole there, and then you want one about an inch from the top, and one about an inch from the bottom. Now I've got a smaller piece in here which might not have caught, so that's got one. Actually, it's only got one hole in, so I'm going to have to do a 5-hole to catch that. So I'll just put another couple of holes in at an equal distance. That might be something to bear in mind if you've got any short pieces of paper. If you're doing a three-hole pamphlet stitch, that the you know that it might not go through it. So I'm going to tie this off on the outside. If you don't already know how to do binding, then I'm sure you can find a video online somewhere. But let's say these are so easy to do because you just do it straight. You haven't got many pages, and you can so I'm just going to do the normal kind of pamphlet stitch method. Actually, put some distress ink on all the threads as well because they were white. So I've gone and done, I've done that, and I've distressed the edges of the pages. So after I've done this, I'm going to go away and I'm going to put finish the cover, put all my embellish, you know, my extra bits and pieces that I've made into the various pockets, and then I'll come back and do a reveal in a separate video, because I think that's, this one's probably long enough now. So we're getting there, I've just got to go back through here. I mean, this is not very instructional, but I'm sure you can, if you don't know, then you can find out how to do a pamphlet stitch. And finally come out through the middle again. And you want to be either side of the thread. Just tighten it up. And I usually just do three or four knots. One, two that way, and then two the other way. I'm not sure why, that's just something I picked up along the way. There you go. And then you can leave your strings long if you want to put anything on them, or have them short, or tie them in a bow or whatever. But I'm just going to cut them that kind of length. I'm going to take my clips off. There we are. All sewn together. Right, so, and I'll probably do some distress ink on the spine, because when you get the holes, you get a bit of white showing through. And then I generally put a little bit of glue on the holes as well, just a spot, just to, as extra security. That's it all put together now, so I just need to go away and finish the cover, and I'll come back and show you the finished item in a little, just in a short part 4 reveal. So I'll see you then. Bye. Thanks for watching. Bye.